Safety first.
Safety first.
Day one of a band.
In a van.
Here we are on the road. And our first stop is Elmhurst, Illinois. Our good friends Kathy and Rachel Richardson live there. You may know Kathy as the lead singer of Jefferson Starship.
It's about time! Yeah. 10:27!
Maybe that's them right now.
Hey everyone, I'm Jeff.
And I'm Misty.
We play in a band called The Newbies, and we own a production company called Lifeboat Digital Media.
In this crazy new world, there is very little work and few gigs to play.
So with production equipment at our disposal and a ton of unreleased songs, we're making the best of the situation.
Yep, we're investing in life.
Built a mobile recording studio, bought a generator, packed up our gear, and we're hitting the road.
We're bringing you along for the ride as we visit inspiring people and places around our great nation.
There's plenty of them out there, and we've got some great new tunes to share with you.
So, join us for a band and a van.
Let's forget about tomorrow and live just for it. Let's forget about tomorrow and live just for it. Forget about tomorrow and live just for today.
When driving through Indiana and Illinois, you get a little slice of Americana, even more precisely, Midwestern Americana. The land written about in so many of John Mellencamp's great songs. From the highway, you don't see many pink houses. And since we were well acquainted with this road, we drove fast and listened to the radio.
Safe to go outside, run like a rabbit and close my eyes. Just for a moment, it's true. We're just living in our holes, cleanse our bodies so we're told. Feel so human once in a while. Well, I know a song ain't playing on the radio. Turn around and ask me why. Well, I see my song ain't playing on the jukebox, honey. It don't matter much to me. Go inside and climb the stairs. Open your arms and take your care. Close your eyes and float away.
It's true. You probably won't hear our band on the radio.
You're still recording.
Not so of the artists we were on our way to see. From portraying legends to working with them, she is becoming one in her own right. Kathy Richardson is an insanely prolific, award-winning songwriter and is the lead singer of Jefferson Starship. Yep, that Jefferson Starship. And we were about to arrive at her front door in cozy little Elmhurst, Illinois. We met Jefferson Starship a number of years ago at a music festival and reconnected via the rock and roll cruise circuit, where the family Jefferson embraced us as part of their tribe. Kathy's wife, Rachel, has been instrumental in keeping us connected.
An angel.
She's an angel.
She is an angel.
And is not only a kindred spirit, but the life of every party she enters. It was Rachel that suggested we make their house a stop on our trip. There was much to be learned from Kathy's passion, mind, social consciousness, and skill.
And then that's the verse and the intro.
And we were quite happy to be having a masterclass in her garage.
Hi, Kathy. Thanks for having us in your garage.
Hey, thanks for being in my garage. Hi, Dean. We're making a little video here. Yeah, we're in the garage.
In the garage, yeah.
We're in the garage. I got all my parents' furniture in here,
yep.
Set up like the living room. And we've got the cameras and the lights and the guitars. And this is going to be worldwide on the interwebs. Yeah, it's...
On the interwebs.
Yeah. Well, we've got Jeff and Misty Perholtz from the band The Newbies that we met on the 60s cruise that we did. And then they were on the 70s cruise. And now here we are in the 2020 cruise in my grandparents' garage. It's actually my parents', but we call it grandparents' garage because they would be the grandparents of our children.
Aww.
Yes.
Let's try a peaceful protest.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
this is a song I wrote with Zach Smith. He's my partner in the Macrodots. We made a couple records. It was really a studio band. We did try to play some gigs back in like 2010. Mm-hmm. I really love the songs that we write together. And I wrote this actually about the Occupy protests. Back then, we were so innocent. And it reminded me of Kent State.
Right.
Where the National Guard actually shot and killed four American students who were there for a protest. That was like the catalyst that ended the Vietnam War because, you know, these white kids had been attacked. Suddenly the peace movement really took over and I couldn't help but see the parallels. Now this was back in whatever year that was. Now here we are. Mm-hmm. With everything that's going on and the civil unrest, and the only thing you can do sometimes is go out and protest and bring attention to your cause, and you can be so peaceful and then get clobbered over the head anyway.
Yeah.
You know,
right.
Now that everybody has a cell phone, scene after scene after scene, you see it play out on Twitter, and you know, it's like, come on, people, you can't say that racism doesn't exist. You can't say that this would ever happen to you as a white person rolling down the street, getting pulled over, that suddenly you'd find yourself in a situation where you were being shot, you know, or whatever. And so thank God for the cameras, but that's what this song is about, and sad to say, it continues to be relevant.
Something's happening, something's wrong. Sides are forming, lines are drawn, rising up like dawn.
Nice. Yeah. That was great take.
I like having the basketball, like, foul shooting contest behind us, too.
Oh, you're good. Come in.
It's a peaceful queso.
It's a peaceful queso.
You're already. You're so quick.
Wow, that was fast.
Whoa. Oh. Donkey chip.
Fight me. No, we're good. No, there's organic happening here. Believe me, it's good. And you know, until you talked about Kent State, but finding Crosby, Stills, and Nash and Young at a young age, and then going to see them in Ohio, and then they played this song called Ohio, which I didn't know. I can't believe I didn't know that growing up.
Didn't they then within days they had the song released and in the hands of the public? That's just remarkable that they could work so quickly.
Just to be so in touch with your feelings and have something to say immediately.
Because the anger that you feel is so visceral in that moment, and you just have to express it. I mean, that's what I'm imagining. Mm-hmm. There's a very big Jefferson Starship fan, Bob Call, who was a student there, and he was there and he was present, and he knew, you know, the song, What If You Knew Her and Saw Her on her Dead on the Ground. He knew these kids, and he will never, ever be able to get over.
Right. Mm-hmm. Right. Wow. Yeah.
It's happening today, people on the streets of America. Mm-hmm. And wake up.
Yeah.
We got to keep protesting. And that's what we do with the microphone.
All right.
All right, ready?
Yep.
One, two, three.
rocks, mates. Mates and mateys.
Bravo, bravo. It rocks, mates.
It rocks.
It really rocks.
It really rocks.
I think so.
My buddy Michelle Hemmer and I, actually she was Jeff's friend before she was my friend, and one of the many benefits that I've gotten from being associated with Jeff Perholtz, I got my bestie Michelle out of it too, and she's an amazing songwriter. And so anyhow, I watched the show on PBS, and I got super excited about like the early part of the women's movement. I'm talking like way back. But I wrote all these lyrics down, like scrambled, crazy, and sent them to Michelle. I was like, what can you do with this? Because I was afraid I'd make it like all dark and broody with my lyrics. And she came back with like the most fun, cute sing-along. I'm like, okay, that's awesome. So awesome. Let's do this. So, got your shot there?
Yep. Yeah,
okay.
Calling out! Shame on the haters and the backward thinkers. Shame on the blatant speaking of oppression. Shame on the silent satisfied with the status quo. Shame on the tyrants and the old boys collective. Leaving tracks of girls feeling less than respected. Shame on the double standards we've come to know. Throw away the frustration, limitations of your station. No obligation to follow the narration. The truth wasn't written about the ones that came before. Demand equal wages in your own emancipation. Seek inspiration from the mothers of my nation. Tell your daughters they're worth fighting for. And we're calling out. You must awaken. You are so skilled. You are for our share. The first pioneers, the reformists, nonconformists who've been fighting it for years. Thanks to the suffragettes for giving us a voice. Thanks Mary Church, Ida B and Jane. Thanks to Florence Nightingale for helping ease the pain. Thanks to the Riveters for giving us a choice. And we're calling out. You must awaken. You are so skilled. You are ferocious. Whoa, should never be ashamed. And we're calling out. You must awaken.
Chit-chatting, we're wasting all the memory.
The memory.
Oh, we're creating memory.
New ones. Yeah. And erasing them. Okay.
Yeah, we're good.
Although we wanted to stay longer, the road west was calling, and the Richardsons assured us that we were welcome back when we had more time. So with the Chicago skyline above the tree line, we put wheels to pavement, but thought it best to stock up on provisions before hitting the open road. After all, who knows what wilds lie ahead?